You're listening to
Catholic Sprouts,
the daily podcast for Catholic kids that strives to plant seeds of faith. Hey there, Sprouts. Today is Wednesday, November 13th, 2019. This week on the Catholic Sprouts podcast, we are talking about counsel, the fifth gift of the Holy Spirit. We have already talked about how the gift of counsel can come directly from God when answer to those questions we might have about how to live out the faith or how to live out these gifts of the Holy Spirit that we have already received. Yesterday, we talked about the sacrament of confession and how oftentimes confession is a great opportunity to receive counsel from our priests directly. Now, today is the feast of a great saint. Today is the feast day of St. Francis Xavier Cabrini. And through her, through this little Italian immigrant who was a nun and founded an order and did incredible things, we can see a powerful example of counsel, of how God might choose to speak to us through other people and how it is our duty to answer and respect his message through other people, even if it isn't exactly what we were hoping to hear. So counsel is the gift of the Holy Spirit that tells us what to do. And therefore, counsel is really the gift of getting things done. It is how God reveals specifically how we will do his will. And so let's look at St. Francis Xavier Cabrini's life for an example of this. Now, as I mentioned, St. Francis Xavier Cabrini lived in the United States, but she was born in Italy. In fact, she was born 2 months early, so she was very sickly when she was little. These days, we have amazing technology, and babies born early grow up and be healthy and happy and completely the same as everyone else. But long ago when she lived, if you were born early, you oftentimes had health problems your whole life. And this was her experience. She was oftentimes sick and very frail. Now, one of the coolest stories from her childhood shows us that she always had a desire to do God's will and to be a missionary to the world, to spread the love of Jesus to places where he might not be known. So when she was a child, she had an uncle that lived by a river, and she would spend most of her time there down by the river making little boats out of flowers, and she would send them down the river with a prayer, and she would tell her family that she was sending out missionary boats to India and China, spreading the love of Jesus to these places that might not know Jesus. And so she went to school and she tried to join an order, the order of the sisters that had taught her, but she was rejected because they thought she was too sick and too frail. But Francis Xavier Cabrini might have appeared sick, but she was a strong-willed, hard-working woman. Since she was turned away, she decided to found her own order. And together with six other people, she did that. Shortly after founding the order, she was determined to really live out this call to be a missionary. So she went to the Pope asking permission to go to China to spread the love of Jesus Christ to China. Now, the Pope was impressed by her, but he said no, she could not go to China. Instead, he directed her to go to the United States. Now imagine for a second here, St. Francis Xavier, her entire life she had been dreaming about going to China as a missionary. She founded an order, she met all this resistance and she kept going, and yet the Pope said no. She needed to go to the United States. So what did she do? She listened to the counsel of God coming through his minister, the Pope, and she went to the United States. The Pope wanted her to go to the United States because at this time, millions of immigrants were coming into the United States, and many of them were from Italy, their home country. Many of them that came in were very poor. They also oftentimes contracted terrible illnesses, and parents would die, leaving the children completely alone because their extended family was still back in Europe. It was a crisis. There were many orphans, children wandering the streets, and someone needed to go there and help. The Pope recognized this need, And he saw in St. Francis Xavier Cabrini a person that could really go there and do good. And let me tell you, that's exactly what she did. She was a determined force. She went to places like New York, Chicago, and other large cities and founded orphanages, founded schools. They did all sorts of things to earn money to support the poor and spread the love of Jesus Christ. By the time she died, she had founded over 67 institutions to help the poor and suffering. She also spread out of the United States, her order did, to places like South America, and eventually they did also go to China. So St. Francis Xavier Cabrini is a great example of, even though we are prayerful, we love God, the way that we are determined to live out his will might not be exactly what we are called to do. And we need to listen to the good counsel and advice of other people, of the ministers that we believe are prayerful also, and follow their guidance. Thank goodness the Pope sent St. Francis Xavier Cabrini to the United States. She saved countless people and created institutions that are still here serving people today. And so, Sprouts, I would like you to pray through the intercession of St. Francis Xavier Cabrini. Pray a Hail Mary and then ask that through the intercession of St. Francis Xavier Cabrini, you also can listen to the good counsel of people in your life and do the work that God has given you. That's it for Catholic Sprouts today. We'll be back tomorrow. But until then, continue to grow in your faith and truly sprout into the beautiful creation that God created you to be. Hey, just one more thing. Today, we have just released a new patch that you're welcome to start earning. It is the Scripture Patch. You can find a link in the show notes to check out all there is about this new challenge patch from Catholic Sprouts. Also, today, for the first time, the School of the Word family study is available. It is St. Paul's School of the Word, a very family-friendly Lectio Divina. For more details on that as well, check out the notes for this episode.